Hello friends, this is Team Super Simplified and today we are here with Paradise Papers. So we will explain this complete topic to you, right? So let's get started. So before going to the main topic, let's understand some of the basics which are necessary to understand the topic completely. So let's understand what is the difference between tax avoidance and tax evasion. So these terms are basically used interchangeably most of the times, but they are very, very different concepts, right? So let's understand what is the difference between them. So tax avoidance is the legitimate minimizing of taxes by using the methods which are prescribed in the law, which are approved by the law. For example, if you talk about income tax, then there are a lot of provisions in the Income Tax Act itself that you can do some kind of saving so that you can reduce the amount of tax liability. Okay, so these are the provisions present in the law which can be utilized, right? And there are some tax credits, some tax holidays given to the firms in certain areas by the government, and by utilizing them, these corporations can minimize the incidence of tax on them, right? So that is a legitimate way of reducing your tax liability. There is another term called tax evasion. Tax evasion, on the other hand, is an illegal practice of not paying the taxes by not reporting income, right? So you underreport your income, you show less revenues so that the tax chargeable will be less, and then you report more expenditure so that your revenue comes down and you have to pay less taxes, right? So these are some of the illegal ways of escaping taxes, of evading taxes, right? And this is completely illegal. So this is the difference between tax avoidance and tax evasion. So in this lecture, basically, we will be talking about the illegal means of tax evasion, right? Now, what are tax havens? This is a very popular term, tax havens. Tax havens are basically the countries or the territories where the rate of taxation is very low, right? So a lot of individuals or a lot of firms, they invest a lot of amount into these countries. They shift a lot of revenue of their firm, and they show that revenue as originating from these countries so that they have to pay less taxes, right? So this is how they take advantage of the low rate of taxation in the tax havens. And there are more than 60 tax havens around the world, like Bahamas, Cayman Islands, British Virgin Islands, etc. And these offshore jurisdictions have strict confidentiality rules, like this is Switzerland, Swiss banks, they don't share the details of their clients, right? So because of these reasons, it becomes very lucrative for the individuals who want to, individuals or the corporations, big corporates who want to, shift their earnings or their revenue to these places, right? And it makes very easy for them to hide the assets because of the strict confidentiality. But now the world's governments are facing a lot of problems because of tax evasion, because tax is a large portion of the revenue of the government, and that is getting evaded, that is getting shifted to the other countries, right? So the world's governments have recently pushed for tax havens to share banking and financial information with national tax agencies, right, which are concerned about the offshore evasion of this by the citizens. Okay, for example, OECD countries have taken initiative to tackle the problem of base erosion profit shifting, right? So this effort is going on very seriously, right? And this is the list of top 20 tax havens. You can see this map, and these slides are available in the link in the description section. You can visit our Facebook page and you can download these slides from there. Now, how does the system work? So this is how the system works. So what do you have to do? For example, you want to evade tax or you want to shift some amount to these countries. So you have to create a shell company. So how is that created? First of all, you select a tax haven. Where do you want to invest? For example, Switzerland. Okay. So you have to create a corporation there, or an entity or a trust or a foundation, some kind of entity, a legal entity. But the thing is, it is only created on paper, right? There is no brick mortar organization or factory or a company which exists in that country. It exists simply on paper. Okay, it is only a legal entity. It has no operations, it has no employees, nothing, right? And then you appoint a nominee who will take care of running the affairs of this company, right, on paper. So this is how you invest a large chunk of your revenue or large chunk of your investment into these countries. Now, how do you take your money back? So what you do is you have to open a bank account, and then you move this money into that account in small amounts which are not suspicious, and then you spend that money, right? That is how individuals and corporations move their assets from the country of their operations or of their residence where the rate of taxation is very high to these tax havens where the rate of taxation is very, very low. And under base erosion profit shifting, what companies do is, if they are operating in maybe 10 countries, so it is a multinational corporation and it operates in 10 countries, and the rate of taxation is very high in these countries. So what it will do, it will create another office in one of the tax havens, for example, in Bahamas. It will create an office and it will show that 90% of its revenue is getting generated from Bahamas. So that because of the double tax avoidance agreements signed with the countries, for example, India has also signed some of the agreements with some of the these countries. So because of that, there will not be a taxation on the company when they fetch this income into the country of their actual operations, right? Because the amount is already taxed in the tax haven. But the firm is getting benefited because the rate of taxation is very, very low. And the country where the entire operation is taking place and where the resources of the country are getting used in these operations, right? So there the government is getting deprived of the fair revenue which it deserves, right? So that is why it becomes a very serious problem for the countries globally, and it is a global challenge. So countries are coming together and they are pressurizing these tax havens to go for the disclosure of the suspicious clients. Okay, so this is the basic. Now let's come to the news headline. So what was the headline? ICIJ releases Paradise Papers. So what are these Paradise Papers and what is this ICIJ? So Paradise Papers are a set of 13.4 million documents. 13.4 million documents. 1,34,00,000 जो documents हैं इसके अंदर, and they are mainly from two firms. ये दो firms में से release हुए हैं, leak हुए हैं. The first firm is Appleby. Appleby is an offshore law law firm based in Bermuda, right? So when we spoke about the creation of shell companies, so you have to take help of one of these companies. Like in Panama Paper case, we had Mossack Fonseca. Here we have Appleby. Right, so you have to go to this company, you have to approach them and they will create a shell company for you, right? So they do the legal work and they appoint a caretaker for your dummy company. So that is what Appleby was doing, okay? And it is an offshore law firm based in Bermuda. And another company from where these documents are leaked is Asia City Trust, which is based in Singapore, right? So these are the two companies involved, Asia City Trust based in Singapore and Appleby based in Bermuda, okay? And a global investigation by ICIJ has revealed the offshore activities of some of the world's most powerful people and companies, right? So the same thing happened in the Panama paper leak also, and there were serious repercussions. For example, the prime minister of our neighboring country Pakistan, Nawaz Sharif, had to resign because of the ramifications caused by the Panama paper leak, right? And among 180 countries mentioned in the leak, almost all the countries are mentioned in the leak. There are companies or the individuals belonging to these 180 countries who were operating through these firms in the tax havens, right? And India has the 19th rank in this list in terms of the number of names, not in the terms of amount, but in the terms of number of names, the people involved, okay? There are 714 Indians which are named in the leak, okay? And what is the source of the leak? The source of leak are two companies, as we said, Appleby based in Bermuda and Asia City Trust based in Singapore. So what did they do? They allegedly helped the global rich and powerful, including from India, to move their money abroad, right? Now what is ICIJ? The full form of ICIJ is International Consortium of Investigative Journalists, okay? And it is a network of more than 200 investigative journalists in 70 countries, right? And who collaborate on in-depth investigative stories. In India, Indian Express was a part of this network, okay? And it was founded in 1997 by respected American journalist Chuck Lewis, okay? So he was behind the formation of ICIJ in 1997, and it is headquartered in Washington DC, US. And earlier 2016, it had released Panama Papers, right? So this agency was behind the Panama Papers also. Now, what is the scope of Paradise Papers? So 382 journalists have investigated this, located in 67 countries, and 120 politicians and country leaders are named in this. 1.4 terabytes of data was leaked, which was investigated by ICIJ, right? And the documents are pertaining to 19 tax havens, right? And two offshore management firms. And these are some of the popular names. So among those whose financial affairs are mentioned are Queen Elizabeth II, President of Colombia, Juan Manuel Santos, and US Secretary of Commerce Wilbur Ross. And according to Boston Consulting Group, BCG, the amount of money involved is around $10 trillion. And the Indian names include Bollywood star Amitabh Bachchan, okay, and defaulter businessman Vijay Mallya, then lobbyist, corporate lobbyist Neera Radia, and then we have Union Minister Jayant Sinha, and another Union Minister and Rajya Sabha MP RK Sinha. And there are some firms also, like Security and Intelligence Services SIS Limited, which is owned by Rajya Sabha MP RK Sinha, and another firm Sun Pharma is also listed in the leaks. Okay, so these are some prominent names. And what is the relation between Paradise Papers and India? So now after the leak has come out, the market regulator SEBI has told that it will look into the alleged fund diversion and corporate governance lapses in Paradise Paper leaks. Okay, if at all any company is involved in that. And there are already panels which are probing the Panama Paper case. So they will now get overburdened with this load also, right? And a very, very important point here, the crux of everything is that mere presence of any Indian entity in an offshore tax-friendly jurisdiction may not amount to violation of laws. Just because they were investing in the tax havens, the investment in tax havens is not a crime, okay? But the non-disclosure about such entities and routing of funds to them could be ascertained only after a thorough investigation, right? For example, companies are expected to declare their investments in their annual reports, their balance sheet and all, and other declarations, right? So if they declare that we have invested in these tax havens, then it's not a problem. So that is what the SEBI is going to do, or the panels which are getting involved in this investigation will do. They will check what all companies are listed in the leak, and then they will try to find out that whether these things were disclosed by the companies or not. If it was disclosed, then it's perfectly fine. Otherwise, they can take action, right? And for example, some politicians are also named. So politicians are expected to disclose their earnings and their connections with the foreign entities or some kind of profit making agencies in the country before election commission during their nomination filing. So now for example, Union Minister Mr. Jayant Sinha is claiming that he has disclosed all these details, and presently he is not having any contact with these firms. He was working for them in the past. So that is what will be investigated by these agencies, and then a clean sheet will be given or the action will be taken, right? So we cannot just say that a person is corrupt just because the name has figured out in the Paradise Paper leaks, right? So that we should keep in mind. Now, what is the difference between Panama Papers and Paradise Papers? So there's a subtle difference, there's a small difference. So Panama Papers had information mainly on individuals, right? So there were very less companies. But now in Paradise Papers, we have information majorly on the companies and corporates. And there are some individuals also, right? So that's all, guys. That's all. Please subscribe to our channel for more such videos, and please provide your feedback in the comment section. How do you rate this video? And if you liked something about it, you can share your views. So please keep watching, and please share these videos with your friends, and please visit our Facebook page and download the slide from there. So we'll meet you soon. Thank you. Bye bye.